Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can create pick list in Salesforce. Before starting, you can also know like how you can search me on YouTube. You can type my name. So here you can watch a series of Salesforce related videos. So in this video, now we have to create pick list. So I'm going to demonstrate you how to create pick list for both custom as well as standard object. So first I'm going to search custom object. So for this application, which is university, I have two objects, employee and student. So I'm clicking on student, scrolling down. So here I have to click on new. So the student is a custom object. So on this custom object, we are going to create a pick list. So pick list is basically a collection of values. So here you can read this description. Pick list allows users to select a value from a list of defined values. So we can define certain values. From those collected values, user has to select a particular value. So I am selecting pick list, clicking on next. So here I have to provide the label. So field label is course. Now here you can see we have two options: use global pick list value set, or you can enter values at your own. So in my another video, you can learn how we can use global pick list or how we can create global pick list and use that global pick list in this pick list. So right now we are going to create our own values for this pick list. So here we need to choose the courses that student can choose. So I am entering first option as BTech, MTech, BBA, MBA, BCom, BSc, MS. So these will be the available values for this pick list. Now here you can see the option display values alphabetically, not in the order entered. So if you want to show these values in alphabetical order, so you can choose this option. So I'm choosing this one. Then use first value as the default value. So if you want to choose the first value as default, then you can click on this checkbox. We can also see the help text. If you enter a valid default value formula, it overrides this setting, right? So right now I am unchecking this option. Then the next option, restrict pick list to the values defined in the value set. So it is by default selected. So it says enforce data integrity with restricted pick list. This setting limits the field to accept only values from your pick list, even if the field is updated through the API. So we are restricting this pick list that we need to choose the values from the defined values. We are not allowing pick list to have values other than these defined values. Then this is the field name that will be known as API name. Then in my previous video, I already explained you about the description and help text. So you can write certain description related to this pick list field. And if you want to show any help text related to this field, you can also enter. And this option is for required. Like if you want, this pick list will be required for each record, then you can mark it as required. Otherwise you can leave it as unchecked. And you can also mention the default value. Now I'm clicking on next. So here you can see we need to set the field level security for the different profiles. So we have various profiles in Salesforce. As per the requirement, we can set the visibility of this field. So here we have two options, visible and read only. If we choose visible, it means this field will be visible as well as you can edit the values. But if you choose read only as well, so it means this field will be read only for this particular profile, that is analytics cloud integration user. So right now I am choosing visible for all so that it will be visible as well as editable for all the profiles. Clicking on next. Here it is asking for the page layout. So we want this field to be available on the student page layout. So now I'm clicking on save. So we have created a pick list field. Here you can see the data type, API name, label. So this is available. Now we need to check it by creating a record. So I'm clicking on new. So here you can see. So if you remember, we unchecked the default as first value, so it is showing none. And all the available or defined values are in sorted form by default, because we checked the particular checkbox which was available by creating this pick list field. So you can choose a particular option from this pick list. So friends, I hope you understood how we can create pick list field for custom object. Now I'm going to create pick list for this. Sorry, I'm not going to create new pick list. I'm just going to edit existing pick list that is available for this account object. And later on, I will also tell you how you can create pick list for this standard object. So again, we need to move to setup. Now we need to type account. So here you can see account related fields will be available. So these are the standard fields. Now we need to search for the pick list. So here you can see it is a standard pick list that is available. I'm opening this one. If you want to check the values, so it has these active values and these are the inactive values, right? So it is having only 5 values. So let me open this account tab. In another tab, if we click on new, so we need to search for account source. So right now it is not placed on the layout. So let me choose another one which is available. Let's say rating. So here it is. So rating has 3 values, hot, warm, and cold. So if we see here, 3 values are available. Now I'm canceling it. I want to add one more value. So I'm clicking on new. So I'm entering so-so. So you can see this value is available here. Now let me refresh this. So I'm clicking on new. And here you can see 4th value is also available in the rating. So this way we can modify standard pick list which are available for standard objects. Similarly, you can also modify the custom pick list that we created for custom object. Now, if you want to reorder these values, so you can click on reorder. So you can choose and you can change the order. You can also select the default values, like you want hot as the default value for each record. So you can choose this. If you want to display values alphabetically, you can click on this checkbox. So it will be automatically ordered as alphabets, not the order which you defined. So I'm clicking on save by choosing none as default value. So now if I refresh, you will see the changed order. Cold is last and so-so is the second last value. Now, if you want to deactivate a particular value that you don't want to use, so you can click on deactivate and you can click on OK. So that value will be deactivated. It will not appear in the pick list But later on, if you want to add or if you want to activate this value for the pick list, you can click on activate, right? So if I again click on refresh, you can see that value is not available here. So this way you can choose various options which are available here. You want, if you want to edit or delete a particular pick list value, you can do so. You can replace values, right? Then if you want to apply any validation rule, any field dependency on this pick list, you can also do so. So that I will demonstrate in my another video. So I hope you understood how we can modify existing pick list that is created for a particular object, right? Now, if you want to create any new pick list for a count, so you can go here, you can click on new. So count is a standard object, so you can create custom pick list for standard objects as well. So you can click on pick list and you can follow all the steps that I demonstrated in the beginning of this video for custom object. So I hope you can follow that those steps to create pick list value for standard objects as well, right? So I hope you understood how we can create pick lists to select a particular value from the defined value set. If you want to learn about multi-pick lists, you can follow my another video. Thank you for watching this video.